So how can a survey of a small group of people measure public opinion of the entire United States? This idea is called random sampling, where instead of talking to everyone in the population, you talk to a group of people who represent the entire population. Of course, if you want to measure what the entire nation thinks, you can't just stand on a street corner and wave people over. That type of haphazard sample would only represent the people near that street corner at that particular time, and you wouldn't get the people that didn't necessarily want to talk with you. A nationally representative survey requires a random sample in which each person in the United States had a chance of selection. Survey researchers have spent decades perfecting methods to draw a truly random sample that includes all ages, all incomes, all ethnic and racial backgrounds, and all political persuasions. We actually use random sampling all the time in everyday life. For example, when you're making soup, if you stir the pot correctly, you don't have to drink the entire pot of soup to know if it needs more salt. Instead, you can just have a spoonful, because each spoonful tastes like the pot of soup overall. That's random sampling. So once you have your random sample, how can you ensure that it actually represents the overall population? A sample could differ from the overall population because some people are more likely than others to take surveys. So pollsters use a standard technique called weighting to adjust for differences. We know the demographic composition of the United States thanks to data from the U.S. Census Bureau. So once we have our sample, we compare the respondents' demographics to the makeup of the whole country. We look at things like age, gender, education, race, and region. Weighting allows us to adjust our survey data so that it matches the general population on these characteristics. So because of random sampling and weighting, we can take something small, like a survey sample, and use it to describe something much larger, like the attitudes of all U.S. adults.